Wait, now I completely lost myself. New colony, finally. Ah yes, shield generators. Yeah, in vanilla you get small, normal and large. At the beginning in this mod you keep researching, you start off without shields at all. Because, well, do we have energy shields? No, so we'll care. So it's a bit more realistic, I think. Well, it's better to my tastes at least. Don't know how you would think. But, well, as you can see, we know we'll have the worst shield system ever, but, well, the first and small useful, well, more useful than nothing, shield generators to actually use the shield technology. And then, some levels later, we'll get normal shield generators and better shield technology. And then, about level 30 or so, the large generators for the best shields. And then we'll just receive new technologies, but, well, we'll add level 8 about average, so that will take a while. So, the new world. Let's take a look. Average. Good. Well, we don't need that much. Now, it's manual. Rare people. Those people need stuff to eat. Agrarian industry. You'll need food. Population growth down 5%, industry down 10%, mining down 5%. Good for tourists. Well, the Rhea are not as emotionless as our weird silicoids, so they'll get government and this thing here to keep Rhea's well, nice, I guess. So, you can keep on researching and growing food for yourself and others, but mostly research. A bit military, well, why not? Military research, and a bit industry. We are, well, mostly good as foot soldiers and building stuff. And since they can actually live in most of those monstrous large worlds, they good with that, I guess, too. But we'll need lots of industry, but we'll need a bit of mining to offset this. Well, a bit. It's not much, but better than just flooding everything with demands to ship off minerals to Matar B6. So, let's do the AI, let's make the AI do the rest, and we'll going on. Our creativity and our picks are proving their worth, lots of positive overdrafts. Now we can armor our fighters, we have our shield technology, and now we can actually build rockets and missiles that are worth the name missile. And we have normal research, our little shield research generators. We have our holiday centers. Those will keep getting built automatically in every recreation center. And, well, lucky that I advised our new citizens to build agrarian development areas, because now this one planet eats more than we can actually produce. That's bad, but well, catalysator. What's that? Catalyzer design. Yes, that makes our industry lots and lots more efficient, and we'll lose not that much minerals anymore. Later on, quite a boon. We'll get a particle projector gun. Yes, I know. I didn't think that about how rare word the abbreviation PP would sound in English, and so You just have to live with it. Think PPG every time you hear it. That it sounds a bit less stupid, but well, I still think it's a step up from Quarkium Gun or whatever it was called in English. So we'll keep it. Changing it now would not do much. So, well, let's just go on. Well, next round. Yes. Oh, we're getting new leaders. And we're getting a colony of the Darlok, the shapeshifters of her, known from such prodigious games as Master of Orion 1 and 2. And already we're about 50 cycles into the future. Well, let's see what the future brings for us. So, the White Doctor here. Let's play MO3, yada yada yada. Let's take a look at our new leader. Oh. LZ195JAYD. More industry, but our people are more upset. Because this AI is, well, inhuman. Even for other AIs. Let's just say, well, we have one for more recreation and less absurd people, and one who does the exact opposite. So at least if we have one, we can have the other. So, well, you are allowed to stay. Lucky machine. Psy Canary. Yes. Now we'll need the second ship rebuilt. So you can take the Cynic 8 round route, and we'll make our first task force. A little detachment for reconnaissance with you, little explorer. You're the first exploration squadron. So, and as you can see, I don't need to punt the beep be on my keyboard, because another change of the mod, you can actually use a task force right away. Yes, exactly. In vanilla, if you make a task force, you can order it around, well, next round. Or you're punting on B, like I do now, like this, and for some reason, if you do it exactly 2 times, you can use your newly made task force normally. A tip for those of you who only have vanilla. 36 rounds. Wow, that's a bit. 7 rounds? 15 rounds? that's hard, but well, without colonies and mobilization centers on, we'll just have to live with it. Daleks, you will soon be part of our empire, but well, our worlds aren't that good. Let's keep on hoping that we'll actually find useful worlds then next time. And we'll, well, need to have some kind of barrier to prevent those guys to invading too soon. So I guess I'll have to take one of these worlds, well, the larger one, and try to make some kind of military center out of it, if you're fast enough. And well, better safe than sorry. And let's just hope that it actually works. Next Star Colony ships. I guess I'll make it like this. And no. 5 of you. And meta conversion module, so we can build normal cruisers instead of light cruisers. Soon we'll have the technology to build cruisers, so let's keep on trucking. Oh no, not again. I think I have said it 3 times already. Hosildain Ruvavi, let's look, what are you? More bureaucracy, people keep getting, and well, we actually don't have spaceports now, so 11% more trading troop spaceports is Well, absolutely useless. Goodbye, Nolem. Goodbye, we don't need you. But I keep forgetting, we'll need soon a few spies, even as some kind of defense. Two from everyone should be... oh, well. Well, now we'll have to wait 10 rounds for two before we can start next ones. So, yes, well, let's just send a few guys, thanks to immigration. And you? Well, better. I make this because if it's an automatic, it will automatically colonize one of these worlds, and if this world is still uncontrolled, then it would essentially waste the entire ship on this world. Now, in about 2-3 rounds, we'll have enough people on Canopus 2 for a new colony, and the other ship will then arrive, hopefully, slow enough to actually colonize Canopus 3. Try to at least. That makes a bit faster. So, Blaymore, Mueller, Unknown, Sea Canary, the next ships sent to Tinan and Nizza because rest of us, there is actually an enemy. Automate, ecologic, automated ecology maintenance stuff we'll need. Essentially, it reduces the amount of pollution, and since we don't know how to we'll need it sooner or later. Hey, new colony, that was fast. Yes, 89 new pounds. Sea Canary 2, nope, you're going to Tinan, and the next 5, then, no, we'll send you to Nizza, because that's pretty far away, and hopefully we'll get there before an enemy colony ship. So, problem solved. So, let's take a look at our 5th colony, and yes, you can actually take that F now. No more immigration for now. Yes, system colony, not that bad, but we also need orbital space yards. You can at least build destroyers and rich. Well, then, why not? Mining. But we'll need industry. Yes. Why not? We are good at industry. More than good, actually, but well, let's combine. Government to keep things on the upside. Research. Stay ahead, and a good old research raise more industry to make a powerhouse of Canopus 2. And, well, that's it, actually. Well, I think recreation, we are here, so, well, why not? And a 4th research development area. So, and sooner or later we forget doing something like this personally, and then our plans will take effect. Now it's still, well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sooner or later we'll have 50, and then sooner or later worlds will simply fall to the wayside. But looky me, I have my development plans pre-made for an entire different race, because I'm lazy. So, next round. Mark Sheo Keynes. Well, Keynes, what are you? Spies and research and still. -1, -2, -3. Taxes, sorry, but go away. Blame or 2 gets a new colony drop. Not like that. Yes, we'll need our army as fast as possible, and we have re-explored the system of Croton. Croton. Yes, a new enemy system. Keep expanding. Too fast. Let's take a look. 6 rounds, then we have 5 colony ships. We're sending 2 here, Tinnen, and 2 more to Nizza. That should be enough. And 1 can, well, go wherever the hell it wants. And Blame or 2. Well, that's a bit not good. But, well, that's rather good. No good worlds, red, everything red. Oh, silicoids, no good worlds for you, nowhere. Oh, rich. Nice, but we'll still have enough of everything, but we'll need actually a few worlds to build an interstellar McDonald's or something. We'll have to wait, I think. Lots of waiting in this game. Oh no, not now. Mining takes a drop because of protests. New colony ship is landing. Now we can use particle projector guns. Yeah, new mining development area starts working. And soil enrichment to make our agrarian development areas work better, which is something we actually need now. And iron engines are researched, and cruisers are in development. And finally, our mobilization center, the most important thing, because until we get mobilization centers, we can actually make new armies or new task forces outside our home system, which is actually kind of bad, because you know, 30 rounds to get 2 Psi Canary is a bit much, but with a mobilization center exactly here, well, it takes 0 rounds, because we can make up the new task force already here. So, finances, how do you look? Well, 322 plus. And we'll still make not much losses. Well, it's on a time. Not much unrest, except of course for our large, warm-like rears. 8, but still everything is content. Which means we can keep on. I don't want to say trucking now. Oh, we have made contact to the Cavalier Empire, and we have deep space fighters. Good news all around. Well, one out of 2 is not that bad. Actually, not for this game. Well, let our empire, our crystal empire, rejoices. We'll found one of the races of the Orion sector. And now we can actually make diplomatic contact. The crystal empire, the emperor of our crystal empire, has declared this day an official holiday. Oh, let's talk. Let's see how long we can make them talk until everything goes downhill. Well, 49, it's not that bad. Especially since we are, well, miserable little fuckers. Let's see how much diplomacy we can do until they start hating us. Oh, that's not good, that's not good. We'll take this world. Now we'll have to at least to get Tinnen to keep them out. Then we'll have to keep reinforcing Tinnen, and then we'll have to push back. But, well, let's not tell them that we're planning an invasion, because that would, well, ruin our plans. And our plans are good, because I say so. Xoras, explored. Well, first reconnaissance squadron, keep on flying. Xoras, what have you? Red 2. Let's see. There's something I can look. Yes. borders. Not out, borders. And now we'll take a look at Xolus. And now we'll take not dominant but Gargantua. Signe for ideal for our new friends. So let's do it. Signe, where are you? Ah, yes, of course. Deep into enemy territory. We'll have to do what we can with what we have, I guess. Luckily, we still have our home world. We saw free with lots and lots of population and industry and all that stuff. And we have our crown guard. But, well, now we're reaching the point where we should design new ships. At least, at first, new ships to protect our systems, and then, well, actually warships. We don't need them soon. And since we can't actually use shields now, well, why not? Let's say 5 rounds, so we actually have iron engines, and then we'll have to design and build and build and build until we can utterly decimate our soon-to-be enemies. But I guess, our first agent is ready. Nemesis. Ugly little green crystal. Yes, something to spice. Dagger, 2. Attack, bad. And cloak, 7. Defense, means essentially he's better at hiding and not getting captured. 7 is actually not that bad, but, well, luck 32, well, good enough. Loyalty can be actually higher than 95 if you research new technology, but, well, it just means that if he gets tortured, he will sooner or later start talking, and his luck will run out over time, and then he'll keep getting useless. More useless. More and more useless. Cloak is good, but, well, he can't do much with Dagger of 2, so we're keeping in the defense. And if his luck keeps getting worse, then we'll have to, well, just deal with it. There is a certain event which will sooner or later mean we'll have to execute a few, retire some of our agents, but that's in the far-flung future of not giving a shit, so we can keep on playing normally now. Our mobilization center is nowhere here, and our new and improved garbage dumps are finished, and we'll have the food we wanted. A new McDonald's has opened on Mata B6. And yes, now we'll positive all around. And 60 minutes recording. Well, that means sooner or later I have to stop. Well, but let's do at least something. And this something is looking at 4. Still 4. No. Now I have enough. At least our home world will now be directly controlled by me. 2% enough for emergencies. And 2 research development areas means 10% is good, and 10% military is always, well, in the beginning it will be enough. And old, new, well, we'll still be making money, which is, well, good, because there was that one time in which I actually ruined my empire financially, but this was about 15 years ago. Since then I always try to keep all my directly controlled planets above, well, zero. Which means, yes, we'll still about 1,000 or so plus, so we can actually make it a bit higher, and it won't do much. This is, well, everything is built, and there is not much terraforming that can be done on a paradise world. So, yes, and as soon as we can actually build something additional, like for example this, our automated ecology maintenance systems, like automatic fabricators, factories, then, well, then it will automatically use our little slider here, economy investment funds. Now our main world is now actually, back to silicoids, geoden, silicoids. Now main view is restored, and next round. Ah, finally, answer from the Cavalarians. Let's hear what the Imsace has to say. Ah, essentially he said, thank you, and now we'll start trading, yeah! Which means at least now 10 points less? Oh, shit. Our ambassador should be executed on the spot, and we'll send a new one to talk about research. Ah, yes, you can already count the rounds to our new war. Yes, mobilization center is finished. Our planetary defenses get new guns shortly, and our cruisers are almost finished. New stuff, but far away. Oh, finally, 60 cycles aboard, 90 Terran years, and now we're getting spaceports. Oh, wow. Bit lopsided, don't you think? Ah, yeah, constitutional monarchy. Our parliament says it's good like that. Miniaturized up to better sensors. Three rounds, then we'll start building like there's no tomorrow. Cruiser finished. Guns for our planets finished. New food, new industry, and a new system explored. Let's take a look. Enoch. Now it's getting biblical. Red, red, red. So many good. One bad red world. Red, red, red one. Lots and lots of worlds, but well. Since essentially typical silicoids only need minerals for food, so not that bad, I guess. And we'll have still rias for certain worlds like Enoch 8. So just do our thing. The larger the world, the better. Especially if you're a species that likes high gravity. So red 2 isn't too bad if you're actually playing silicoids, and red 2 is some large hunk of a world you normally wouldn't want to colonize. Ah, yes, tenants soon to be. Bad. We'll try at least to take ten before we'll actually to attempt to infiltrate enemy space. I think it's better. Well, two rounds, then we have our colonization effort, and two rounds, and then we can. Hey, actually, not that bad. Because even if I start designing now, I would have to wait two rounds until our colonization ships are on their way to new worlds. Ah, a positive message. Ah, yes. Ah, very funny. You can browse, boast and brag all you want, but, well, we'll see. Oh, real actually kind of nice. And they are nice to us, and all is well. But we can take a picture of victory and actually look what they are thinking. Ah, yes, mild. We'll have actually contracts with each other, and we'll kind of apathetic, and all is quiet on the Western Front. Now, next round. New colony ship landed on Tinan, and 5 new spar built, and iron engines are finished, and now we can do our stuff. And Psyops and Planetary Defense Force, why not? Psyops is actually psychological warfare, not psychic as you would maybe think, but no, it's propaganda. Propaganda is good for the Crystal Empire, so we'll build a few of them for our later armies. Blamer 2, why not? Sea Canary? No. That is a phenomenally bad idea. One here. And you attempting to infiltrate Nitzer system. 16 rounds from you. Blamor, you are two in Sierra system. It's well, why not? Tinan, take a look. No, not back. This tiny speck I wanted to see. 500, even with immigration that takes too long. Take a fast ship and that should be enough. And Blamor, well, why not? A few new worlds, a few rounds of a new. But, well, next time we'll making our war fleet. Still peacefully everything, but, well, war will come. It is already on its way. And now, instead of peace and prosperity, I'll prepare by changing to peace through strength. And next time, well, our preparations for war are starting. So the white dog door locks out, and we'll see each other next time. My audience, goodbye.